Hello, and welcome to this edition of Crawdaddy Cosplay. Today we will be assembling our Space Marine Mark III Heresy Era shin piece to go with our thigh piece that we made in our last video. So let's go ahead and dive right in with part one. Part one is going to be the back side of the shin. It consists of three parts. The back side of the shin, which is part one, the outside front of the shin, the big plate is part two, and then the little knee ball is part three. So this piece has a fair bit of detail on it, so we'll just go ahead and dive right in. First part is part one alpha. All cuts are straight cuts on part one alpha. Second piece is one bravo. All cuts are straight cuts on one bravo. Note that we translate the registration marks here to the outside. What we're going to do, our plan here, so we're just going to attach this piece and wrap it right around like that. So the wall will come down a little and then be flat where it hits this 10 millimeter foam. But that lets us get the little stepped kind of ziggurat look like we had in our thigh. This little ziggurat style right there. We're going to redo that here in the back part of the shin. Part one Charlie, all cuts, straight cuts on one Charlie. Got part one Delta. And on part one Delta, all cuts are straight cuts again. Translate those registration marks over. Also note, like right here in the middle, we got spots here and here, which are where the edges of one Foxtrot 1 and one Foxtrot 2 will be. The back detail is going to come down to this bottom lip right here and actually attach to this piece right here and not one of these walls. Part one Echo, all cuts are straight cuts. Nice little detail that's going to go in right there. And then we get part one Foxtrot 1 and one Foxtrot 2. One Foxtrot 1 and one Foxtrot 2. One Foxtrot 2 is a mirror of part one Foxtrot 1. We got some undercuts here. We got 45s on the tips and then 10 degrees along the back. Not here on the little straight parts where it's going to actually interface with our ring right here. That part needs to be flat and it's marked on the template. Make sure you don't accidentally do that. Part one Golf, which is the top of our little box that's going to go on the back. Got 45 degrees on the ends and a 5 degree on the top. If you can't get that 5 degree, that's fine, but I've got a bandsaw. I can dial it into 5 and get 5, no problem. One Hotel. One Hotel has two 45s, and because it actually is gonna interface with this part directly, it doesn't need an undercut. All right, and we got part one India. All cuts, straight cuts on part India. This part, like I've done in the past, you've seen in a few other places, it's just going to rest right on top of there. We're not going to bother to 45 it, which is why I've translated the registration marks for alignment with parts 1 Foxtrot 1, 1 Foxtrot 2, 1 Golf, and 1 Hotel to the sides. It's just going to rest on top. That way we avoid a 45. When this, you get to really thin pieces here, you try not to throw angles on those, bevels on those, because it's going to, depending on how thick the foam is, you might end up destroying the thickness of the foam. I'm not having enough foam there. So what we're doing here with this is just like on the back of this right here, where we've got this piece right here with the steps that go in and out. We're doing the same thing with this right here. So that's where these detail pieces, one India one right here. So we got, let's see, 2, 4, 6, 8, 9. We got 9 of these pieces, and they're just gonna go on, starting at the top like that, every other, and work our way down. We also have these detail marks, one tech one. These will go on one Alpha and one Charlie, where you see the overlap areas. So that takes us through one India, one Juliet. One Juliet is an ankle ball, unlike the Primera Shin, which has like two ankle balls on it. This shin only has an ankle ball on the outside. So this piece here, we'll seal up these relief cuts, we'll make our ball shape, and then we'll attach it to part one echo right here. So that brings us to part one kilo. So now we need a way to interface the back of our shin, part one, with part two. That's where part one kilo and one lima come in. Part one alpha will mate here, one Charlie here, one echo here. And so on part one kilo here, for instance, we've got a 90 degree V groove here in the back, and then we got just a surface cut right here. What that's going to let us do is we're going to put this in, and we're going to fold it this way and this way. And these bends right here correspond with the bends here on part one echo. But what that's going to do is we're going to get that on there, and then we'll have this nice straight surface here, or at least relatively straight surface, and our outside shield, the front of the shin, will actually mesh. We'll get attached directly to that. One lima is the piece is not symmetrical, so one lima, so the opposite side is not a mirror, I guess is what I'm trying to get at. You'll notice it's actually a little thinner. Again, just like with that 90 degree V groove and a surface cut. And that's a lot of parts, or a lot of sub pieces for our part one. So let's go ahead and start putting these bad boys together. Thank you. it. Some of these pieces are ready to start putting together, so let's go ahead. It's your turn yet. While we're doing that, we might as well get the overlaps here for the little back detail that we made. For this little ankle ball here on part one echo, you look on the template, this registration mark right here is going to be longer than the rest, and that's supposed to align up with this one here that's longer than the rest. So you have the registration marks, four of them on here, and then you have the four seams for the relief cuts. So the relief cuts line up with the, these marks line up with the seams and the registration marks. So and there's our little outside ankle ball. All right. So when we bring the back down there, when we bring the side shield, well, the front shield in and attach it, that tension will help pull these sides in here and get this to the shape that it needs to be for our left shin piece. But this is piece one, so let's go ahead and put this on the shelf and get on to piece two. This piece should be very similar to something, the pieces you've seen already, particularly the thigh piece we just did. So we got our front plate. Alright, so let's go ahead and run through our pieces here. We got something to be said for this entire part. All pieces are straight cuts on this part. Part 2 alpha here. Again, like I said, I'll cut straight cuts. Make sure on the top and bottom you translate those marks over for when you're lining up your detail. And on the back, we've got registration marks in an overlap area for part 3 Charlie, which is going to help support the knee ball for part 3. Part 2 Bravo. Again, on the outside edges, translate those marks over. And then again on the back, we've got overlap for 3 Charlie, and we've also got an overlap here. This is 2 Bravo, so this would be part 1 Kilo. Part 2 Charlie, again, translating those marks over. And then overlaps there for part 1 Kilo. 2 Delta, translate those marks over. And we got 3 Charlie again, and this time we got 1 Lima and 2 Echo. Again, those marks go over so we can line up. And we've got the 1 Lima part right there we're going to line up. We've got 10 of detail 2 Tac 2, the little bolt heads that are going to go on the armor pieces there. And then we've got detail 2 Tac 1, which you don't have to do this all as one piece. If you can't find a piece big enough, you can do it in sections if you need to. I like to do this piece as one piece. I like having it with no seam. But you'll notice a lot of registration marks on this because it's important that you get your bend right as you're lining this up, because it's going to help keep your shield in the right shape. So it's just going to go together like you saw when I had it laid out. So we'll get these pieces attached up together. We'll get the details on. And then we will move on to the next part. why this contact cement is setting up, let's go ahead and introduce part three here, which is our neem. So we have the knee ball itself, which is part three alpha. All cuts are straight cuts on this part. And we also have some details, little bolt heads, three alpha one to go on here, a little armor accents. Got six of those. And we got part three Bravo one. Three Bravo one has a 15 degree undercut along the long side. And what that's going to do is we're going to wrap this around into a cylinder. And then we're actually going to fold, seal up these relief cuts, and then mate this surface to that 15 degree undercut. And it's going to help us get the shape we want there on the dome. It's intended that the curved side face in, because if you look at the top, I've got it dipped in to make room for the your leg. And the seam should be pointing down, but in general, you'll see registration marks and overlaps on here to align it with this part, which is part three Charlie. This part will attach to the knee ball itself, and then on the overlap, attach to the back of our faceplate here for our shin to put our knee in the proper location. So you probably noticed I put a little bit of masking tape on there just because this TNT foam is really rigid, very high density, and it's not going to like the strain I'm about to put on these joints as I flex this material around to give it the shape that it's going to adhere to in order for this detail to go on here correctly. So do not try to put this detail on with this being flat. It won't work. The detail, if you just try to lay it on top, you would see it's too large because it assumes a curve and then the detail piece is 6 millimeters, so it assumes a 3 millimeter neutral axis of curvature for the dimensions that I used for the part. So it'll be too big. So you've got to basically walk it around into its final 3D shape as you attach the detail, just like we did with the thigh. There are registration marks on both sides, but I find I don't really need the inside. This allows me to choose one side or the other for overlap, and you only need both side marks when you're on the parts that actually curl. The edges aren't really three-dimensional parts. There we go. Start walking that around, and you'll start to notice that the registration marks aren't lining up as easily, and it's because you're going to have to put a curve on the part to get it. Whoa, that's too much. There we go. Going on here. too far ahead of ourselves. Well, it's a bit of a chore to get everything to come together right, but it looks nice in the end when you finally do. Alright. Our seams are still holding. Alright, let's go ahead and set this piece off to the side and get part three constructed. First thing we'll do is seal up the relief cuts. Seal up this part, get three alpha attached to three Bravo, get our details on, and then get the whole thing attached to three Charlie. Then we're ready to attach part three to part two, and then part two to part one, and then we're done. It's not ready yet. Unfortunately, we're going to have to wait, and this is our last part, so there's not a lot of discussion to be had. Again, I don't like to edit. I like for people to see everything and warts and all, the entire process, and I'm not really good at it at all anyway. So now's a good time to hit the fast forward button, see where it takes you. Not worried too much about these seams at the edges, because part 3 Brava will help keep those together. So I guess we can take a moment to talk about how we're going to bring these pieces together. So you get the part 1 kilo and 1 lima here on either side. And you'll see where those parts have corresponding overlaps here. So all we'll do is join this up together and join that up together, and it's actually going to have a fair bit of tension in it because I left out some undercuts and stuff like that just to make sure that it was a good tight, nice tight fit, and it should get us to where we need to be. So again, we were clear, we want this to be at the bottom, so this right here is going to go at the top. So that's the 6 o'clock, that makes this the 12 o'clock. Let's go ahead and go down to the bottom and start wrapping our way around. And the long lines should gonna line those up with the seams as best you can. And obviously the overlaps there should continue to line up. You're gonna feel a lot of resistance because you're helping form that dome shape too. So you're putting a lot of tension in the dome on here to help force it into the final shape that we want. Not necessarily going to be very happy about that. Go ahead and get some cement on this overlap here. I'm gonna freshen up what we got on here just a little bit. While that's drying, we can go ahead and get this piece ready to go on to part 2 as well. Thank you. so that's how that part goes on here. So this is how it's going to go on here. It's still got a tacky appearance to it, so let's go ahead and do another couple minutes. Good time to use that fast forward button if you got it. Well, you don't, it's not an if, you do have it, but. It looks like we've got our, so you're gonna notice it looks like stuff's off center, and it is. This is not a symmetrical part, and it's not meant to go on either foot. But the one shoe will come out, it'll look right when it's all together. But that's the shin piece, and that is to go with this piece here to make the leg. So this is our Space Marine Mark III Heresy Era shin piece. Thank you for joining me, and let's get you back view there, side view. Thank you for joining me, and I look forward to seeing you on my Etsy store. Thank you.